deep within. I can't go through it alone, and I won't leave you on your own. I stand before you now and promise you I am not afraid. I will fight and guide the way. We will rise again to glory, then soar into the sky. If you stop and see,
I will not betray her trust.
What she doesn't know won't hurt her. Besides, don't you want to be human so you can be with her and not put her in any danger?
Stop it!
Stop it? What makes you think you're in a position to say no to me?
I won't do it, Diana. You can't make me do this.
Oh, can't I? Your precious little human isn't here to save you.
Well, you're not doing this to me, but you're breaking.
What? Are you not enjoying yourself? You're an incubus, and even more than that, a man. Surely you can enjoy this treat in exchange for your precious humanity. She was a cute little diversion. But now it's time to have some real fun.
Huh? Hey, what's wrong? Huh? Hey, come here. Everything's okay. It was just a nightmare. I'm right here.
His voice helped me slowly start to relax, knowing that what he said was true.
I told you before that it was fine. Honestly, it's nothing to worry about. I cannot be any happier than I am now. I'm marrying the woman of my dreams as a human, an actual human. I owe everything to you. Yeah, I figured why not have breakfast in bed. James's big toy review is today. Do you mind if we watch it?
All right, so here we have an interesting story to tell. The Anderson Toys Company, an internationally famous toy business, has just recently announced a new line of toys in development. According to the CEO, the line is said to focus on fantasy. Let's take a look at the public announcement.
I am more than happy to show off our new line, Fantasy Kingdom, for you all this morning. These toys will not only provide friendship and fun for children around the world, but will help inspire imaginations and let creative minds grow.
Here you go.
They are! Only a couple of them are real, though. Vampires are real, but they don't look like that. They look like humans. I promise it's true. Werewolves used to exist too, though they were killed off by the vampires long ago. Let's see. There, the angel toy? Angels are real too, only they don't look like that. Well, they look... They look like old statues. It's really hard to say without drawing it out or something. I don't think many people would understand it. Though it would be cool to have a demon doll.
I guess you're right. They are for kids after all. I looked to Damien as he became absorbed in the line of toys. I couldn't help but smile at how intrigued he was. It made me curious. Hey Damien, did you ever have toys as a kid? No, because he lived a horrible childhood. Ugh. Damien looked at me in surprise before shaking his head with a slight grimace.
No, I didn't. Matthew made some for me sometimes, but they were always...
Oh, no! I frowned. I was sorry for asking, but Damien shook his head again and smiled.
However, when we came to the human world, I actually... It was a stuffed kitten. I didn't do anything, but it was fluffy and cute. Must be dumb, huh?
No!
A grown man
no!
with a cute toy like that? You are so adorable, you know that? It's true. And what if I was enthralled by you? Maybe we should eat a bit before we continue this, huh? she all right?
I wouldn't worry about her, you mistake! She will never leave this world alive as long as I live!
Demon Lord, and prepare another spell in her hand.
Go with her. I'll deal with this once and for all.
If I'm going to fall here, all of you will fall with me!
Into his shoulders. Was this dream going to end with us dying? As Damien pulled away, I saw tears begin to form in his eyes. I stared as he
keep her safe.
You're powerless against him!
You're faster than me as a demon. I won't be able to get out of here fast enough for us both to survive.
You will not be forgotten!
As he managed to get his feet around the Demon Lord's neck, a large avalanche of stone and glass fell over their bodies, hiding them from sight. I couldn't be sure, but it looked as if they had been crushed. No!
Another nightmare? You can't control your dreams.
You said that before. My memories flash back to the first time he said that to me. Cheeks as he looked up at Damien. You told me that when we first met. Damien gently pulled away and smiled at me, kissing my cheek. It was the day right after.
I did, didn't I? You remember that?
Came to the human world and arrived at my house.
No matter what comes our way, I promise to protect you and love you for the rest of my life.
To his shoulders and ran through his hair, brushing through the strands lovingly. He shivered at my touch, making me tremble in response. The thing was, I had just
Are you sure you want to do this? I don't think I'll be able to stop myself if we continue. I am yours, forever.
Aren't you so proud of yourself? You didn't answer my question.
Leave me alone! Why should I? Show yourself! As I looked at the mirror, I gasped.
How does it feel to be inches away from marrying the man of your dream? A frisky bridezilla, aren't you?
Answer me!
Tell me first. How do you feel now that Damien's no longer who he was? Remember, he was born a demon, and you took that away from him. Well, I did anyway. At your request, of course. You don't even know who you're marrying, do you? Damien, the human who was a demon. What's next? Will he demand to be a woman instead? He could easily be one. Oh, wait. He can't because he no longer has the ability to do so himself. But do you even know what he wants? I want to go to the human world. I want to be human. Tell me, can you give him everything he wants? I want my mother back, ever a demon. I want to forget I was even born.
I knew it! I knew it! That girl has demon magic.
Then quit talking, and let's take her!
The Demon Lord will be so pleased.
Me in. I shut my eyes. Please let this be a dream. Please let this be a dream. I finally felt a stir.
You! What are you doing here? What are you doing here?
My lady, please forgive me. I felt something moving between our worlds and assumed the Demon Lord was to blame, so I intercepted his summoning of this human.
You? So I wasn't the only one who felt the change in the air. Can you tell me what happened?
Is she okay?
I don't think so.
This is a waste of our time! Just kill her and-
Yes, because that's a smart thing to do. Kill someone who is clearly traumatized and has done nothing to deserve death. Brilliant idea. Bravo.
Censor her somehow.
Can you stand? First, can you tell me what happened to you? A shadow summoning. One of yours couldn't have.
On my honor, it wasn't any of mine. We have nothing to gain from kidnapping a human. Nor do we know who this woman is, anyhow.
My lady, if I may, I clearly remember hearing imp demons in the void along with her. It must have been the Demon Lord's henchmen.
Those damnable creatures. That explains it. Well, dear, it seems that you were to be either a new harem girl for the Demon Lord to ravish, or bait for the boys to return to their father's side. Either way, I doubt you would have lived long had the Demon Lord gotten his hands on you.
Wait a minute. This girl knows about the Demon Lord's heirs?
Yes. Hilariously enough, she was set to marry one of her garb. Well, since you do not belong here, the obvious thing to do is to send you home. It should be easy to do once everything is in order. It'll be like you never left the human world. Dear, do you not realize where you are? You are in the demon world. Do not panic. We will send you back now, so there's nothing to worry about.
How will you power the spell? Bringing someone here is no easy task, but sending someone back consumes much more energy.
I'll use what energy I have now and rest. We can organize the siege another time when I fully recover. It's not like the Demon Lord can escape the corner we've trapped him in, so we do have some time to spare.
You'd waste time and energy on this human! We must strike now while the Demon Lord is weakened!
But the human doesn't belong here. She needs to go home.
Shall I prepare the return spell?
Do. I grant you permission to use my energy to power the spell.
Open the gates to the void, and allow passage to the world we seek.
Transitum perennam peto tenibris. Ubi aperiut, nianoium, desidium.
You must leave now. The faster you leave, the quicker we can close the void.
Go! Go! Go get married!
How dare you interfere with my... Human! Use the passage! Now!
The human.
Close it!
I don't sense the demon lord anywhere.
The worm has to scurry through the shadows to try and fight back. He'll be dead soon enough.
How is she, guard?
There are no physical wounds, but she's been weakened. I must give her my energy so she can recover.
There's an imp in the castle. That is the only way the demon lord could have been able to interfere.
You! Guards by the door! Hunt it down! We'll get you home, okay? Diana just needs a little rest, okay?
She needs more than rest. She needs to use a different spell to send her back. The demon lord will expect her to use the shadow spell again.
How about the normal way? I'm sure we can connect to a witch or even the warlock she used before to reopen a portal to the human world.
The warlock she used to get to the human world died, remember? And he was the most powerful warlock in the human world. Practically a god himself! What other human could be used to open a portal without another human dying?
It was merely a suggestion. The faster we get this human home, the faster we can move on and finish off the demon lord.
Well, what are we going to do with the human now?
We can give her a room to rest in. Humans need sleep after all. Maybe by the time she wakes up, we'll think of a solution.
Come.
My heart ached, but I had to accept my predicament.
Here, I'll bring you to the open ambassador's room. You are free to rest there for now. She'll be fine. She's being taken care of right now.
Why not just say she's getting...
And the brute strikes again with the lack of tasteful filtering between his brain and his mouth. You still have yet to prove me wrong about my expectations of you.
Keep testing me, assassin. I'm not afraid to rip your spine out of your body and use it as a back scratcher.
You can very well try, brute.
Ugh! Would you both knock it off?
Come, everything will be taken care of.
Well, you did it! Congratulations! You've made it to the end of your story. I have to say, I am very surprised at how it turned out.
Woo, we finished making all choices, but we still have some left, though. We still have some, a little bit of ending left. Let's keep going.
Nevertheless, I'm glad things worked out in the end, whether it was for the better or otherwise. Despite everything Damien went through, it was all worth it to obtain his humanity and to be truly happy, don't you think? He got his revenge for his mother, and both of you saved the demon world. I definitely would put that down as successes.
Hell yeah.
Anyways, you've been through a lot, so why don't we skip to... Huh? You want to know what happened after the war?
Yes.
Well, I mean, I guess I could tell you. After the war was finished, the entire rebellion celebrated. Word spread far and wide about the rebellion's success, and soon every kingdom in the Abyssal Plains had become united with the new authority. You would think demons would be more hostile towards each other, being demons and all, but the threat of the Demon Lord was what brought the entire world together. The entire world united under one banner, the Lilith Crest. Diana became the sovereign of the entire plane, accepted and loved by practically everyone because of her devotion to the world and her bravery in the war. And, thanks to you, she was finally able to find true love in the form of a tainted Nephilim named Sero.
Hey! Yeah! We helped them to get together. I'm so happy.
Oh, crap! I shouldn't have let that one slip. Oops.
No, oops, I want to know.
Anyway, when they bound their souls together in marriage, he became king of the demon world. However, it was just a title to him. The real power belonged to Diana.
Oh my god, they got married! I'm happy right now. So happy.
Diana became one of the most beloved rulers in all of demon world history. Her natural heart of gold led her to lead the world to a prosperous future, one filled with peace and happiness. The other rebel leaders supported her, eventually changing the caste system of the world and slowly working their way towards a plane as equal and peaceful as it could be. Diana had her suspicions, of course, as any monarch would, but if they had any sort of bad thoughts about her before, they certainly didn't during the recreation of the world. And I believe that is everything that happened after, well, except for your story anyway. Damien and you, both completely human now, return home and set up once more for your wedding. Take two. Huh? How do I know? Well, I have my ways. Maybe you should check it out.
Yes.
I hope I didn't hurt you. Thank you.